Washers and dryers can cause homeowners a lot of problems. Washers can actually flood your entire house, and a dryer that malfunctions can cause a fire. So to help homeowners avoid those problems, we're talking to Richie Isaacson. And Richie, you've been working on these things for a long time.
Over 30 years, and I've seen plenty of catastrophes.
All right, well, let's hear about some tips to avoid those catastrophes. Well, let's start with the washers.
Yeah, one of the problems that we have, one of the main problems, you see this hose right here?
Yeah.
See it all rusted?
I do.
If that bursts, you're going to have water all over the place.
It's going to go everywhere, isn't it?
Just like a reservoir in your house.
Whether it fails here or anywhere along
anywhere
this rubber
along
tube
there, if
right
it gets
here.
A bubble or it gets anything that's corroding, yeah. It's going to just burst along.
How do you feel about the rubber hoses?
I don't particularly like them. I like to use stainless steel braided hoses.
Mm-hmm.
And even though they're stainless steel braided hoses, they still should be changed every 5 years because they're always under pressure.
Okay, so preventive measure, just get rid of these things after 5 years and put some new ones in.
New ones.
What else?
Well, you don't want to overload it.
Yeah.
If you put too many clothes in here, what's going to happen is, first of all, it's not going to wash. Mm. And second of all, it's going to be uneven, it's going to be unbalanced, it's going to be all over the place.
Yep.
And you're going to end up breaking parts on it, so you don't want to be overloading it.
Two smaller loads instead of one huge one, right?
Exactly. The next thing is take all foreign objects out of your pockets. Keys, coins,
toy
your
trains,
wallet, toy trains,
rocks, the kids.
Mattel toys, everything. Take them out of your pockets.
Okay.
They'll cause a major problem, and you'll have a lot of repair service people.
Good. All right. So this is a top loader,
yeah.
Right? Sort of an old school model.
This has an agitator. This moves the clothes, but an agitation system.
Yep. All right. So top loaders is one option, but there are some newer models out there.
Yeah.
Front loaders, and you know, obviously, clothes go in sideways from the front. And to your point, there is no center agitator.
Right. It just tumbles the clothes one way, and then it stops and goes the other way, and then it keeps doing that to wash, and then at the end of the cycle, it goes to an extremely high spin, and it gets the clothes really wrung out pretty dry.
And that's what people like about these.
Yeah.
They wring out the clothes so you don't spend as much electricity on the dryer.
Correct.
And you can actually save some water on these. So they're water, efficient models.
Yep, water and electricity, and it's a great saver.
But there's different soap that we have to use. Is that true?
Major problem if you use anything but HE soap, high-efficiency soap, because you're going to have it oversuds, it will not work.
So you have to use the high-efficiency soap
have
in these machines.
It.
No choice.
All right. No choice.
The other thing, too, with that high speed of the spinning is sometimes you get some vibration, or it can actually kind of walk its
way
out of its spot.
That's right. Here's to prevent that. We have something that's called a vibration pad. The vibration pad actually has the leg, goes right inside there, and it stays on the floor to a point where it can't slide because it's got a nice hard rubber here, and everything is good when it goes into a high-speed spin.
All right, so this is a good solution, but
yeah,
at the very least, just make sure that you've got this device nicely leveled.
Nice and level. Yeah, there's leveling legs on the unit if you need to.
Good info. All right, Rich, you talk to me about dryers.
Dryers, biggest problem, lint.
Wow.
Right here, you see that?
That's a lot of lint.
I'll tell you. See this lint filter?
Yep. Ooh, full.
Full of lint.
Okay.
You need to empty this lint filter every time you do a load.
Every time?
Not every other time, not every week. Every time you do a load.
All right, well that one hasn't been emptied, but
that's not good.
Tackle that.
Different kind of venting available. This one is called a flexible vinyl.
Yep.
Not code anymore.
This is not code,
no,
huh?
Nope. If you see it anywhere, like if I see it, I change it immediately.
All right, so I mean, the idea here is that this can, what, heat up and burn?
It gets heated up and it gets fire hazard possibilities.
Okay.
This one's a little bit better situation, even though it's flexible. It has fire retardant aluminum, so it's at least it's got that, but you're still gonna get all sorts of lint all in the corrugated pieces here.
All right, so that's not ideal either.
Not ideal. This
Something
is another
like this.
One. Yeah, a little bit better. And this one is a little more rigid. And it's a little better flow, so this is the next step up from those.
Mm-hmm.
But the one that's absolutely preferred by all the manufacturers is solid pipe.
And so we're talking very rigid, smooth on the inside, so that we don't have any place for that lint to get hung up, which means it's going to pass through here with a lot less problem.
Right, but even though it's solid and it's smooth, you still want to service that every year to try to get any lint out of it.
So this is not maintenance-free,
and
the idea here is that we're going to probably have to pull this dryer out, get access to this, and you know, get something up
clean it out. Get going with it.
All right, maintenance once a year at the least. All right,
yep.
So some good tips on washers and dryers and preventing problems. Thank you, Richie.
Thank you.
I could not agree with Richie more between making sure the dryer venting is clear and to be sure you change those hoses.
Yeah, and those are ways to prevent problems, but you know, there are appliances out there right now that are so smart, they can actually diagnose the problems for you.
Really?
Yeah, so we got a new washer and dryer at my house, and the dryer, not that long after we got it, it wasn't getting the clothes dry. So we picked up the phone and we called the company, and we're figuring we're gonna schedule a service call.
Sure.
Well, they said, no, wait a second, take the phone, put it down to the dryer, push a special button, and the thing started talking to it. We got back on the phone and the person said, it's not the equipment, you have got a blocked vent. And sure enough, we did, and it saved us a call.
Wow.
Yeah. I tell you, the technology is moving fast because you had to call somebody. There's now an app right here that you can put on any smartphone or on a tablet.
Well, you one-upping me.
I don't mean to be. So now in this case, we say audible diagnosis. Now tell it what the unit is. In this case, we'll say a top load washer. So then I hit the power button on the washing machine, then I hit record right here. Did you hear that?
Yeah, sounds like a fax machine. Yeah.
But that sound is actually coming from the washing machine, and the app is picking up and it's discerning what's going on. So here right now, it's analyzing. So now we hit next. Look at this right here. Huh. The drain hose is bent, pinched, or clogged, so it knows.
Amazing. That's amazing.
Well, the washer's smarter than you are.
That's not hard.
All right, well, very cool technology. So until next time, I'm Kevin O'Connor.
I'm Tom Silva.
I'm Richard Thuey.
And I'm Roger Cook.
For Ask This Old House.
That's pretty cool.
Hey, give me that thing, right?
No.
Hey, I got the talking dryer.
What am I going to do? I don't even have an iPhone.
You clearly don't clean your clothes.
What?
Ever.